name is Don Aslett. I've been in the cleaning industry for about 59 years. I started a business when I was 19 to work my way through college. It was a fun thing to go through and learn to clean and raise a family and everything. And I had trucks and my name and everybody thought I was a big wheel of a college student. But when I graduated, it was a different world. I found out that cleaning, even though it was fun to me, had a real poor image. People didn't think much of cleaning. In fact, I guess I was going in a bank one day and a lady had a little kid coming in. The kid was being ornery, and pretty soon she shook that little kid and said, "Behave, you little snotty. You're going to end up like him." And she pointed to me. You know, so I found out that cleaning image was not the easiest thing to overcome. In the industry, we have skills and we have the best products and everything, but we're, to the public, we're really indivisible. People don't know we're around. So anything we can do, which has been my push in life, anything we can do to make cleaning come up front, we do it. For example, I clean hospitals and I found out that the doctors and the nurses and everybody had their pecking order, but the lowest pecking order were the janitors. We were the people that sold the supplies and cleaned the floors and everything, and the doctors would strut through the place with their stethoscopes and everything, and we'd all bow and scrape. And one day I thought, you know, I'm just as good as a dentist. We both work in the enamels. What's the difference? So I went out and basically built me a bowl brush, put electric cord on, put it around my neck, walked through the hospital like everybody else. It was the greatest thing. People believed it. I could have given this to most doctors, and they wouldn't know what to do. They'd probably, this thing isn't working, you know, and everything else. So in all my life, I guess my whole life's been dedicated to making cleaning where it belongs is number one. I think the value of clean beats everything in the world except maybe probably the word faith. I mean, I'm talking about clean air, clean floors, clean sheets, clean language, clean mouth, clean water. Anything clean is delightful. And that's the industry I'm in. And I'm really, really enthused about all the things we can do. One of my big enthusiasms as I'm older, I'm almost 80, is I decided to start a cleaning museum. And everybody says, a clean museum, what do you mean by that? Well, we have articles we've kept for years and years and years and years, so some stuff up to 2,000 years old. I even got scrapers that the Romans scraped off the sweat, the squeegees they had in my museum. So we're building one of the largest museums in the world in Pocatello, Idaho, of all places. We're making a destination museum where people can come, and we have an art room in the museum, and people say an art room, but everything in that room is cleaning art. We build a kids' cleaning world. And the kids come in and they clean, and we have a giant vacuum. The kids walk in, they get vacuumed off first, they learn to recycle, they learn to sweep, they learn to do all the type of things like that. So basically, I guess my bottom line is my whole life has been spent, my money, my time and everything, is to raise the image of clean, to teach the value of clean, and teach that it is, I think, the most important profession in the world.
To view more quick clips, visit ISSA.com.